First time I worked with U2 was Elevation Tour, which was, you know, which was fundamentally a rock and roll show.
We'll get that tonight, thank you.
Vertigo was structurally a development of the staging philosophy of Elevation. So for both shows, I kind of relied heavily on the classic principles you need when you're directing a live concert film. Innocence and Experience was really, really intimidating. It was scary. I mean, it challenged everything that I knew on so many levels. First of all, structurally, it was incredibly challenging because you had this giant screen down the middle of the room. So there was a real fear in my heart about how I was physically going to cover this number of angles on live television. Okay, take it up. Let's see his performance on 13 is good, 11 is good also, 11 is good. But what blew my mind were the multiple narrative arcs combined with a number of emotional arcs that you are taken through as you journey through the show. You know, directing this live for HBO really scared me. It was a technical nightmare married with a real creative roller coaster. I felt this huge weight of responsibility, as you always do when you're working with U2, but you know, I was like, how do I do this? Am I the man up to this task?
So this boy comes up to me.
17, stay with Edge. 12, give me audience,
like
please. Five's good. Five's good, thank you, five.
I set about breaking down the show into kind of little modules. The first bit was actually very straightforward. It's punk, it's four guys from Dublin, it's kind of handheld, it's loose shots on dollies, it's using and harnessing the energy of the crowd, shooting through their hands. And then from the visceral power of the punk section, there's a very abrupt halt, and Bono takes you through a gear change into Iris, and we introduce a new creative tool, which is this giant screen in the middle of the room. So there's quite a lot of creative challenges to deal with at this point. Many people were saying, well, you know, just go full frame on the footage. And I was quite adamant that I didn't want to do that because that would have taken the viewer out of the room. But it presented an issue because for me, it was about how we relate Iris to Bono and then how we complete that story and relate the band members. Let's just keep it in the room, hold wide, and allow the viewer to absorb the occasion.
The star gives us light.
What I had to do was really think very, very carefully about what each camera was doing within each song. And we created a booklet which was 100 pages long, which was essentially a shooting script. And so the cameraman knew emotionally what place they needed to be in. What's the story I was trying to tell? Was this kind of anger? Was this love? Was this loss? Was this joy? And then also they knew that actually this particular wide shot with this element in here relating to that band member there was really, really important. So they had a very, very clear narrative that they had to follow. It looks pretty basic, but it's it kind of Bible, really. It became the Bible, which I would refer to many times, and I trusted it. The great joy about these live event shows is that, you know, you're going into someone else's art, and, you know, you've obviously got the band, their music, their art, and it just makes me realize how special that show is, how blessed and lucky I am to be asked back by the band to work on it and to work with Willie, to work with the band, to work with Smasher, Jake Berry and Alan Branton. These projects don't come around very often. There's a lot of good shows out there, but there are very, very, very few great, great shows out there. Wrap that all up with what happened in Paris, and it's absolutely a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And it's one that I will cherish forever.
We are all Parisians tonight.